Hey everybody, today's restaurant is called the Sugar Mill. It's located in Kalihi, and as you can see, I'm walking in the parking lot, and you can see New City Nissan right across the street, and there's the First Hawaiian Bank. It's right next to Mitsuken, so you can see their very, very long line, but the secret is there's no long line next door. That's the Sugar Mill. It might look closed because they have a special decoration thing on their door, but it is open from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. Monday through Fridays, and they serve local plate lunches with a unique fancy twist. So it's kind of like an upscale plate lunch. They're famous for their fried fish, so we're going to start with that. They have other creative items such as turkey adobo, some chicken long rice, lau lau plates with fried butterfish and such. I wanted to do something different that you don't normally see every day in plate lunches, and this is their fried fish. You gotta call in and see what kind of fish they have. So this is their fried taape. If you don't know what taape is, the English word is, I believe it's blue snapper or blue striped snapper. It is an invasive fish. So you're doing some good to the Hawaiian waters by eating the fish. It's not a bad fish to eat. It's just an invasive species. So we're gonna dig into this. I'm gonna squeeze a little bit of lemon on here and take a taste. With your fried fish, you also get some chili pepper water for those who want some spice in their life. And let's dig in. So here's a piece of the meat. Nice white fleshy meat. Hopefully there's not too much bones in here. I love fried fish. So this reminds me of just down home cooking, but fried in a really good way, probably using a deep fryer, so it's much more crispy than pan fried. And the meat is pretty tender. It's nice white meat. I don't taste or feel a lot of bones. Tender on the inside, super crispy on the outside. I think he fried it so crisp you could even eat the fins and the tail because it's just going to fall apart. Let's try some of this chili pepper water here. This is definitely hard to eat in the car though. We'll dunk the tail end into our chili pepper water and try it out. Not too spicy at all. And yep, fried to a crisp, so you can eat all the bones. Just like a potato chip, almost. It's delicious. I really like how there's a lot of meat on here, and there's no little bones. Really easy to eat, especially for a plate lunch. And it's a very mild tasting fish. It's not fishy, you know, like that stinky fish smell. It's just really nice white meat. And this is pretty much just the bones that you get is the middle spine and like on top of the fin, and that's it. Everything else is meat, and it's you know, you're not struggling with little bones in your mouth, so it's actually a perfect fish for a plate lunch. Very unique. You don't usually get fish like this. Usually it's filleted mahi mahi or something, but a fried fish, it's absolutely wonderful. Very good tasting, simple flavors, but delicious and crunchy. The textures of the soft meat with the crunchy outside skin, it's so good. This would be really good if you had your homemade shoyu vinegar sauce. Spread that on the fish and you're set. This is the mac salad. We'll take a taste. Pretty flavorful, but it's just a typical mac salad. It's not bad. For those who like mac salad, you'll probably enjoy it. It's al dente, not too soggy. And of course you get your scoop of rice with it. So all in all, very good plate lunch. The chili pepper water to me wasn't too spicy. So if you're afraid of spice, it's not too hot and it'll be perfect for you. Just the right amount of mild heat. Now, if you're wondering if they're gonna stay there very long, I hope they do, but it's considered a pop-up restaurant, which means they're only temporarily there, but hopefully they do well and they just stay or move somewhere else permanent. But it's headed by Chef Lawrence, and he is a friendly guy, super awesome. The guy at the register, he's a Kiwi from New Zealand. Love his accent, super friendly as well on the phone and in person, so definitely support this local business. Very good talent in cooking. I love it. So for today's fish, the choices were fried aku, the taape, or I believe they had uhu too, but I wanted the taape. And for all those choices, whatever fish you pick that day, the fish of the day, it is $16.50. Quite a pricey plate lunch, but where else can you get a deep fried, perfectly deep fried, nice fish, whole, and it's fresh and it's unique. You don't get that anywhere else in a plate lunch. All right, so for our last item, I wanted Saimin, I craved it. So they have a thing called Pig Two Ways Saimin. And I'm gonna open it up and see what it's about. Brah, look at this, it's a hefty bowl. I don't wanna spill it, but inside, definitely Pig Two Ways, big chunks of chasu, kalua pig, and big pieces of fish cake. Got my green onion, gonna sprinkle it on. And here we go. This thing is so hefty and heavy. My little mobile table for my car is not, it's over the limit. It's starting to bend, so I'm gonna hold it and eat some of the kalua pig. Smells delicious. The combination with the smoked kalua pig and the chasu, the sweetness of it, smells so good. Mmm. Yummy. There is so much meat in here, I don't even know if I can get to the bottom with the noodles. And it's hot. Some good chasu. I don't know what the red stuff is. Looks like pepper flakes, not sure, but we'll take the noodles and taste it. Typical delicious Saimin noodles cooked perfect. It's not soggy. It is piping hot. It's burning the bottom of my hand. So definitely you're getting it hot and fresh and made to order. Mmm, that's good. And the broth coating the noodles, delicious. And naturally, with the regular base broth, it's mixing with that smoky kalua pig taste and the juices from it. So it's really giving it its own flavor. Mmm, actually, those little pepper flakes kind of have that essence of kimchi. So good. So actually, I've been craving the Saimin for a while. I've been wanting to go here 2 weeks ago, but unfortunately they were closed that day. So definitely check out their website just to make sure if there's something going on or they're closed that day so you don't waste your time going there. Or I would just suggest calling them right at 10 to make sure somebody answers and that they're open, which they did answer. So that way you're not wasting your time or anything like that. But I was craving it so bad for like two Fridays ago. And now I'm here and it did not disappoint. Let's take a taste of the broth. Mmm, it's nice. But once the juices from the kalua pig kind of mix in it, it does get a little bit salty, but nothing terrible. You just definitely need some water or a drink next to you just to flush it down a little bit. But when you eat everything together, it all melds well with the noodles, the starch, and the meat, and it's not as salty. You're definitely not going to be hungry when you finish this. Definitely worth every penny, I think. Like I said, this is kind of like a luxury plate lunch place, so some of the prices are steeper than other drive-ins. But look at this thick piece of chasu. And I think there's 6 pieces still in here, and I ate like 3. So very generous, big, thick slices. You can't go wrong. You're going to be full and satisfied. And not to mention, look at all this kalua pig, and I didn't even grab it all. Tons of meat in here. Definitely worth it. So for the price of the Pig Two Way Saimin bowl, that was hefty and filling and delicious and full of meat. So all you meat lovers are going to love it. It is $12. Pricey, but like I said, worth it. I think that thing weighed like 2 pounds. The thing is heavy, and you will definitely be satisfied for sure. All right, just another tip, they do not separate the broth from the noodles, so definitely eat it as soon as you can when you're ordering it, or when you order it, time it right where you know you're going to eat it right away and you have time to eat your food. Otherwise your noodles will get soggy. But I opened it right when I got it here in this parking lot, so it is perfect, cooked to perfection, lots of meat, noodles are not soggy, cooked just right, has that nice Saimin chew and bite, and everything was delicious. I am very impressed and so happy that this place is so delicious. I hate when you kind of get excited about a place and you're all hyped up and then it just does not meet your expectations at all. And this place, the Sugar Mill, definitely did. Chef Lawrence is a talented chef, bringing his skills to give it to you in a plate lunch form. Definitely check out their website, like I said, to look at pictures and descriptions of all their different creative plate lunches that he's trying to bring back from local plantation days and just local food and give it a little spin-off and a little bit of a upscale version of it. So yep, check out the mill in Kalihi. And I don't think you'll be disappointed at all. Skip that long line at Mitsuken and go straight to their place, which had no line at all. Well, I went right at opening, but he had showed me all his receipts on his fridge of all the orders they had already, and they were a lot of orders. So they're doing pretty good, and they're doing a Christmas package with a prime rib as well. So they do cater for your Christmas dinner or lunch. If you want to buy that, you can look on their website again for it and their description of their prime rib Christmas dinner. And he said they were doing really well with that. So that's great to hear from a small business just trying to do their thing here in Hawaii, which is very hard. So until next time, I'll see you again on another food adventure. Support a local business and press the like button if you like this. Subscribe if you're new, and I'll see you again. Peace out.